The Tale of Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves, retold by Eric A. Kimmel, illustrated by Will Hillenbrand. In the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate. Once upon a time, two brothers, Qasim and Ali Baba, lived in the city of Baghdad. Qasim the elder had shown great skill in buying and selling ever since he was a small boy. He married the only daughter of a wealthy merchant and inherited his property, thus becoming one of the richest men in Baghdad. Ali Baba, on the other hand, possessed neither talent for trade nor a wife with a fortune. He earned his living as a woodcutter. Every day he led his donkey to the forest beyond the city walls and brought back a load of firewood to sell in the streets. With these meager earnings and his brother's grudging charity, Ali Baba managed to support himself and his family. One day, Ali Baba's search for firewood led him to a place in the forest where he had never been. He noticed a dead tree growing out of a rocky hillside. Ali Baba tied his donkey to the trunk. Then he climbed the tree and began breaking off dried twigs and branches. Suddenly, he heard the sound of hoofbeats. Looking down, Ali Baba saw a troop of 40 horsemen approaching. Each rider carried two leather sacks slung across his saddle. The riders stopped at the foot of the hill. The sheikh, their commander, dismounted. Walking up to a large stone, he pronounced the words, "Open sesame!" The stone rolled aside, revealing an opening in the base of the hill. The entire band rode in. The stone closed behind them. Ali Baba trembled, for he recognized these riders as thieves who would kill him at once should they discover his presence. After a while, the stone rolled aside. The 40 thieves rode out again, having left their sacks behind. "Close, sesame," the sheikh said. The stone rolled over the opening, concealing it as before. Satisfied that their secret was safe, the thieves rode away. As soon as the band was out of sight, Ali Baba climbed down from the tree. Approaching the stone, he pronounced the words, "Open, sesame." The stone rolled aside. Ali Baba walked through the opening. He found himself in a spacious cavern lit by oil lamps hung from the ceiling. Sacks of gold and silver coins lay in heaps besides piles of rich carpets, silks, and brocades, and baskets filled with jewels. Ali Baba dragged three sacks of gold dinars out of the cavern, then said the words, "Close, sesame." The stone rolled shut as before. Ali Baba loaded the sacks onto his donkey. Covering them with firewood to conceal them from curious eyes, he started back toward the city. Upon arriving home, Ali Baba shut the door and uncovered the windows. He emptied the three sacks of coins onto the table. There was so much money that the table couldn't hold it all. Gold dinars rained on the floor. "Father, where did you find such wealth?" Ali Baba's wife and son exclaimed. "I may not tell you," Ali Baba said, "except to say that I broke no law, nor did I rob any honest man. Come, help me count it." Ali Baba's wife and son helped him count out their newfound wealth. But with so many coins to count and the hour growing late, Ali Baba decided on a faster way. He sent his son to his brother Qasim's house to borrow the bushel measure. What does my brother own that needs to be measured by the bushel? Kasim wondered. Curious, he smeared a dab of fat on the bottom of the measure. When his nephew returned the measure the next morning, Kasim found a gold dinar stuck to the bottom. He ran at once to Ali Baba's house. What is this? Kasim cried. Have you become so rich you now measure dinars by the bushel? He gave Ali Baba no peace until he revealed the secret of the cavern and the treasures it held. If one poor donkey can haul away such wealth, think what I can bring back with my 12 strong mules, Kasim crowed. Repeat to me again the secret word that opens this cavern. Open sesame, Ali Baba told him. And to shut it, you say, close sesame. I beg you, brother, do not go. You have wealth enough already. Why risk your life for more?